of liberty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, in His holy name. Amen. Amen. The book of Numbers.
Yes, sir.
Chapter 21.
Moses
good, I tell Abram that he better get his house in order. Because when he get to the mountaintop, he's gonna die. Bring Eleazar with him that the priestly role might be transferred to him. So that there will be a priesthood continually. And after this, Abram died. The text says that when they came down out of the mountain,
right,
and they noticed that it was Moses and Eleazar. So they perceived that Moses and Eleazar had buried Abram in the mountain. Because the text says the congregation noticed that Abram was dead. They then, amen, according to the text, mourned for 30 days. And all while this was going on, amen, there was a king in the land of Canaan.
Right,
a king, amen, by the name of Arad. Arad dwelt in the south as Israel journeyed along. Amen, and Arad had heard the story of how Israel sent out spies when they got ready to overtake the land. And so he decided, amen, that he would war against Israel. And in so doing, he took some of the Israelite prisoners. Is that right? And the text says that Israel vowed a vow unto the Lord. And said, God, now if thou will indeed deliver this people in our hands.
All right.
Then will we utterly destroy them all. Amen. We will destroy the cities. We will destroy everything that they have. The text says that the Lord heard their prayer.
Yes,
the Lord hearkened to the voice of Israel and delivered and they utterly destroyed them and their cities and called the name of that place Hormah. And the blessing here is not in the prayer. The blessing here is the obedience or keeping of their word, what they said to God. God, if you will deliver them in our hand. God, we bow into you that if you let us have them, we'll destroy every one of them. And God, we bow in this to you, God. We got a solemn oath. We're bound to carry it out, God. We bow this to you, amen. And we promise you we're going to stick to it, God. We bow this to you. Solomon said, now fifth chapter, Now for a verse, when you vow a vow unto God, Solomon said, defer not to pay it, for the Lord hath no pleasure in fools. Pay that which you have vowed to the Lord. Then that fifth verse said, better is it that you should have not vowed than to vow and not pay it. You got some making up to do. You got some making up to do. You better do some more praising. You better do some more studying. You got some making up to do. Because you know in the midst of going through, you promised God you were going to shut out for him. You were going to give it all to him until you got what you want, and then tell your neighbor, don't lie, don't lie, don't lie. If you mean it, you say it. But if you don't mean it, God is still holding you accountable. And you're not going to get back. I don't care how saved you are. I don't care how sanctified you are. I don't care how Holy Ghost filled you are. If you promise it to God, God waited. They vow a vow.
That's all right now.
And because they kept their end of the bargain, God kept his end. How many know God always keeps his end? Amen. How many know God won't let you down? God won't fail you. Now can we say we have not let God down? Defeat Arad,
yeah,
and the Canaanites.
Come on.
They travel on to Mount Hor. This is where Aaron is buried.
Yeah.
I better read it. For what I think I know what I'm talking about. On that journey southward to Edom.
All right.
The Bible says that they journeyed from Mount Hor.
Right.
By the way of the Red Sea. The land of Edom.
Alright.
And the soul of the people were much discouraged because of the way. Now that's strange to me that the children of God would get discouraged because of the journey. Because they know who's leading them. Well, how do you know they know? The Bible told me that when they left Egypt, they are hearing me. When they crossed the Red Sea, Bible said that when the pillar of cloud moved by day, then the children of Israel moved. It said when the pillar of fire moved by night, then the children of Israel would move. So if God is leading them, why in the world would they get discouraged? Isn't it strange when you know God is leading the way, and yet you still find yourself discouraged? Well, maybe God didn't get them there as quick as they feel like he should have. Maybe God didn't take them the way they thought was the right way. Maybe God didn't take them the way they wanted to go. But God got a way of getting you to your destination. I wish I had some witnesses here. God got a way of getting to shut up. Bless his holy name. They spake against God. And they spake against Moses. Notice what they said. Wherefore have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? Now, if it was that bad, amen, in Egypt, why in the world would you get out here and cry about going back? I wish somebody understood what I'm saying. Amen. And then on the other hand, if it was that good in Egypt, they were tired of the light bread. Light bread. Salt. They began to complain.
Yeah.
Even though the Lord was taking care of them. Too many times we walk around complaining. And even though the Lord we sat in the house of the Lord, talking about God is the head of my life. But it's true that the Lord do something different. We begin to complain. I told y'all at 8 o'clock, I tell the whole story. When you go to the 11th chapter and the first verse, they complaining about their misfortunes. But I come to tell y'all, things just happen. Don't you damn complain. When you get down to the fourth verse of the 11th chapter, they complaining because they got bread, but they don't have. Pop out and fight them. That one. Shit.
Tell somebody, they look at me, I'm the blessed.
Let them mind.